नमो नमः। लेट अस लर्न संस्कृत वर्सेस। वर्स नंबर 27, छिन्नोपि रोहति तरुहु। लेट अस लर्न बोथ संस्कृत एंड संस्कृत वर्सेस। योर को स्टूडेंट एस एल अभ्यंकर। फ्रॉम सुभाषितम नंबर 26, तत्सादृश्यम अभावश्च। वी लर्न दैट निगेटिविटी has six shades, but basically negativity is in the mind. This Subhashitam number 27 advises positive attitude. Chinnopi rohati tarushchandra kshinopi vardhate loke iti vimrushantas santas santapyantena lokesmin. Padachedehi छिन्नः अपि रोहति तरुः, चंद्रः क्षीणः अपि वर्धते लोके इति विमृशन्तः संतः संतप्यन्ते न लोके अस्मिन्। अव्ययानि अपि मीन्स आल्सो, इति मीन्स लाइक दिस, न मीन्स नो नॉट, तिङन्ताः रोहति, रुह प्रथमगणीयः परस्मैपदी, टू गेट अप, टू अराइज, टू ग्रो, लटि प्रथमपुरुषे एकवचनं, वर्धते वृद्ध इति धातु, प्रथमगणीयः आत्मनेपदी, टू ग्रो, लटि प्रथमपुरुषे एकवचनं, संतप्यन्ते, संतप प्रथमगणीय परस्मैपदी, टू हीट, टू गेट एंगर, टू टेक डिस्टर्बेंस मीन्स टू बी डिस्टर्ब, कर्मणि प्रयोगे लटि प्रथमपुरुषे बहुवचन, कृदन्ताः छिन्नः, छिद इति धातु, टू कट तस्य क्तकृदन्तम्। अत्र पुल्लिंगि प्रथमा विभक्तिः एकवचनम्, क्षीणः क्षि इति धातुः प्रथमगणीयः परस्मैपदी, टू वेयर, टू रिड्यूस, टू बिकम लेस, तस्य क्तकृदन्तम्। अत्र पुल्लिंगि प्रथमा विभक्तिः एकवचनम्, विमृशन्तः, विमृश इति धातु, षष्ठमगणीयः षष्ठगणीयः परस्मैपदी, टु थिंक, तस्य शत्रुकृदन्तम्। अत्र पुल्लिंगि प्रथमा विभक्ति बहुवचनं, संतः, अस इति धातु, द्वितीयगणीयः परस्मैपदी, टू बी, तस्य शत्रुकृदन्तम् सत्। अत्र पुल्लिंगि प्रथमा विभक्तिः बहुवचनं, तरुः सुबन्तः, तरुः, तरु इति प्रातिपदिकम्, प्लांट, ट्री, पुल्लिंगं प्रथमा विभक्तिः एकवचनं, चंद्रः, चंद्र प्रातिपदिकम्, मीनिंग मून, पुल्लिंगम प्रथमा विभक्ति ही एकवचन, लोके, लोक इति प्रातिपदिक, मीन्स वर्ल्ड, पुल्लिंगम सप्तमी विभक्ति ही एकवचन, अस्मिन, इदम इति प्रातिपदिक, सर्वनाम, धिस। अत्र पुल्लिंगं सप्तमी विभक्तिः एकवचनं, तद्धिताः नैकमपि तद्धितम् अत्र, समासाः नैकोपि समासो अत्र, समासोत्र। अन्वयार्थः, लोके तरुः छिन्नः अपि रोहति, इन द वर्ल्ड प्लांट ग्रोस इवन वेन कट, चंद्रः क्षीणः अपि वर्धते the moon waxes also after waning. Iti vimrushantaha. Thinking like this, santaha asmin loke na santapyante. Gentlemen, wise men in this world do not become heated, do not get angry, do not get disturbed. Chando vishleshan, chinnopi rohati taruh, dvi dvi ekam, dvi ekam ekam, ekam dvi, kulataha dvadashamatraha. Chandraha kshinopi vardhate loke, chandraha dvi dvi, dvi dvi ekam, dvi ekam dvi, dvi dvi, kulataha ashtadashamatraha. Iti vimrushantas santaha, ekam ekam ekam, mru ekam, well, rukar, not mru, this is mru plus ru, rukar, and rasva, so eka, eka matra. Shantaha, because of conjunct consonant, sh gets two matras. Taha, because of the visarga, it gets two matras. Again, santaha, because of taha, conjunct consonant, sa gets two matras. And taha, because of the visarga, gets two matras. So, kulataha, dvadasha matraha. Santapyante na lokesmin. Dvi, because of nta. Dvi, because of pya. Dvi, because of te. Te, ekaran, so dvi matra. Dvi, 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 dvi. Eka. Loke, dvi, dvi, smin. Dvi. Kulataha, panchadasha matraha. Aryavrutam idam. Yasya pade prathame dvadasha matra tatha tritiyepi ashtadasha dvitiye panchadasha chaturthe sarya. Perfect. Aryavrutam idam. No, stipanya. Etymology of the word lokaha is interesting. It is from dhatuhu lok, meaning to see, also to be seen. So lokaha encompasses whatever is visible, hence the world. So the world is an extended meaning for the word lokaha. Otherwise, its grammatical meaning becomes whatever is visible, lokaha. But almost all mythologies speak of three worlds, this world, the nether world, and the heavens. Indian scriptures mention saptalokaha, swargaha, bhuhu, bhuvaha, swaha, mahaha, janaha, tapaha, tat, sat. Bhuhu is this earth, so I am omitting that. So above earth, above bhuhu, there are sapta. Bhuvaha, swaha, mahaha, janaha, tapaha, tat and sat. Accordingly, there are sapta patalaha also, below the earth. Waters and there below, sapta patalaha. Sapta swargaha, sapta patalaha. Evam, chaturdasha lokaha, totally 14 lokas. This corresponds very well with environmental layers on earth. Earth and above being troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, exosphere, ionosphere. So the rishis identified the six layer environmental layers above earth by their own tapascha, by themselves. Maybe they also could go up above in the atmosphere and understand that the environmental layer, their quality changes. So the modern science has given them the names troposphere, stratosphere, but rishis realized it long, long ago. Bhuvaha, swaha, mahaha, janaha, tapaha, tat, sat, and all that. Anyway, chinnopi rohoti taruhu. Tree, even when cut, grows. This brings to mind a beautiful poem I had read and has stayed in my memory. No matter how often I level this weed, it springs again after rain, as if there is need. No matter how often I level this weed, it springs again after rain, as if there is need. Beautiful. It seems the word loke should be taken common to both chinnopi rohati taruhu and chandraha chandraha chinnopi vardhate. Both being laws of nature, loke can as well be interpreted as by laws of nature. Taru chinna api rohati, chandraha kshina api vartat, laws of nature. With taru rohati, a law of nature, and chandraha vardhate, a law of astronomy. Na santapyante should be the law for everybody. But asmin loke, in the world of humans, only santaha na santapyante. Humans are different from other things in nature primarily because of their intellect. Has a poet woven in an irony, upahasaha, as a figure of speech? In spite of intelligence, all humans do not keep cool. They do not have the positive attitude. They do not have the confidence that bad times will pass. They do not follow the law of nature. How sad. There is such a beautiful prasa, a beautiful and pleasant onomatopoeia, prasa, in Itivim Rushantas Santas Santapyantena Lokesmin. Onomatopoeia. By its vyutpatti, santaha is visheshan, adjective, shatrukrudantam of us to be. So literal meaning of santaha is those who are. But santaha has come to mean gentlemen because not only that they also recognize that to be is the fundamental right of everybody. So their philosophy is live and let live. By having inculcated this philosophy, santaha are gentlemen. They would not harm anybody. Live, let live. Using santapyante in passive voice is some smartness of the poet. Friction creates heat. Santaha have no friction with anybody. Hence, santaha do not get heated up. Santaha may experience heat due to tapascharya, their own tapascharya. In that case, santaha santapanti is active voice, affirmative. Santaha na santapyante, even when hurt, is negative and passive voice because they are passive. They do not retaliate tit for tat. Interesting? Iti shubham.